Hello and welcome back. So today I decided to record a Q&A sessions for you, and actually I am talking about this problem. So this is one of the problem for mathematical induction chapter. So you know that actually I have give you this problems in your class when I am taking you in class in physically. So then on the time I gave you that problems, and in maybe in some sections I already solved these problems, and maybe in some section I left as an exercise to solve that for you. But I decided today that I will going to solve these problems, and so does this video. So here we have to go to the problem. So here what we going to do, we have to prove by mathematical induction. So prove by mathematical induction that, so here we have the statement. So it says that 1 into 1 factorial, 2 into 2 factorial, 3 into 3 factorial. In this way, any n, for any n, n into n factorial is going to be equals to n plus 1 factorial minus 1, and the statement is true for all positive integers n. So what is the statement actually? So let me write that down. So before going to the solutions, what we have to first do, so we have to first find, so solution. So let me erase this first, because I had to write it in more face way. So here is the solution what we have. So here the statement is PN. So statement PN is that 1 plus 1 into 1 factorial. So again I made a mistake, so I have to erase it first. So 1 into 1 factorial, so you can write into in this form, or 2 into 2 factorials plus 3 into 3 factorials and so on in this way. So for any n into n factorial going to be equal with n plus 1 factorial minus 1. So here we have to show, this is our statements, and here we have to show that PN. So we have to show, we have to show that PN, the statement PN is our statement is true for all positive integers. So for all natural numbers, all positive integers n. So what we going to do, so first of all, what is P1? So P1 means, P1 is, so let me say what is P1. P1 is when I going to put the value n equals to 1, we will get P1. So by putting the value n equals to 1, we get P of 1. So that means, what is that? Which is 1 into 1 factorial. So we get 1 basically. So in this left hand side, basically here we are talking, this is our left hand side and this is our right hand side. So let me so here in the left hand side we get 1, and right hand side we get, if I put the value of 1, we get 1 plus 1 factorial minus 1 and 2 factorial minus 1, which is 2 minus 1 and 1. So you can see that this is equals to clearly the left hand side of the equation. So the statement is true for the P, the statement is true for, so PN is true true for n equals to 1. So actually when the, so the best case for this induction is, so best value or best case is 1 basically. So I just said this is not in actually the in the problem, but I decided to show you, so you can skip this part in your problem. So here, so for some of you may ask, what about the, if I put n equals to 2, we will get the statement P of 2. So what is P of 2 actually? What will be the left hand side of P of 2, which is actually equals to 1 into 1 factorial plus 2 into 2 factorial. So this is our left hand side. So if I put 8 equals to 3, what will be our left hand side? Left hand side will be 1 into 1 factorial plus 2 into 2 factorial plus 3 into 3 factorial. So in this way the statement is going on. So if I put n equals to 100, so if I put n equals to 100, what we have to do? We have to go in this way: 1 into 1 factorial, 2 into 2 into 2 factorial, 3 into 3 factorial, plus 4 into 4 factorial. We do not want to write all this part. So let at the last we have to 100 into 100 factorial. In this way it's going. So that's how the statement is. We can write that statement. You can skip that part. So this is not in actually the problem, but I just show for some of you. So how the statement works basically. So here we go. So what is the second step or the next step of inductions? So in the next step of induction, so first step is we show that in first step that for n equals to 1 the statement is true. So next step, what we're going to do, so you can write as it's as a step 1. So you can write is as step 1. So what we're going to do in step 2, so in step 2 we're going to write that we assume, so we are assuming the statement. So it says that what we assuming, so assuming that the statement PN is true for n equals to k. So k is our any natural number. So we are assuming that this is true for any integer k. It is true for any integer k. So that means if I put the value n equals to k, the statement will be true. So then what we have, if I put n equals to 1, so we get 1 into 1 factorial, 2 into 2 factorial. So in this way we get k into k factorial in the left hand side, which is same with in the right hand side, which is basically k plus 1 factorial minus 1. So this is the statement. We are assuming that this statement is correct. So this equation basically is correct. That's what we are assuming. So what we have to do in next step, so in step 3 we have to show. So let me erase the first part or the step 1. So what we're going to do, so let me erase that part and write down the step 3. So here we have the step 3. So what we have to show in step 3, we have to show that PN is true for n equals to k plus 1. So if we assume that the statement is true for n equals to k, what we now have to show, we have to show that the statement is true for n equal to k plus 1. So the next step of this is the case step, and here we have the not the case step. So if I put the value k, then we will get this part, and for n equals to k plus 1 we have to show that the statement is still true. So what we have to do, what will be the left hand side in that case? The left hand side will be, so we are assuming this is our as left hand side. So if I put n equals to k plus 1, we get 1 into 1 factorial, 2 into 2 factorial. So in this way we get k plus 1 into, so k plus 1 factorial. So k plus 1 into k plus 1 factorial. So what we can write it's as, so we can write it's as 1 into 1 factorial, 2 into 2 factorial. So you can see here you have 2, then the previous step is 1, just so only 1 decreases. So here is 1. So here we have 3 into 3 factorial. So the here you have a 3, just 1 decreases, we have 2, and here we have 3 minus 1, so 2. So in this way, suppose we have k plus 1, so the next previous step of k plus 1 is k. So we can write k into k factorial plus k plus 1 into k plus 1 factorial. That is what's there. K into k plus 1 into k plus 1 factorial. Thus the previous step is k into k factorial. Now what we're going to do, so we're going to do a clever thing. So here we have this, the value of this, so 1 into 1 factorial, 2 into 2 factorial, in this way up to the addition up to k into k factorial, the value is given that this is have to be equal with, because we are assuming that this value is same with k plus 1 factorial minus 1. What we're going to do, we put the value. So here from you can see that here we have that part up to k into k factorial, 1 into 1 factorial over here. I think you can pause the video for a few seconds or a few minutes and look at these two terms, this term and this term are equal up to that point. So we can put the value of that point over there. So after putting that value, what we get, so here after putting the value, so what we're going to do, so we put that value, so the value is so here we go, so here we can write it's our k plus 1 factorial minus 1. So that's the value up to k into k factorial, and then we have this part left. So that remaining parts, I have to write the remaining parts. So remaining parts is our k plus 1 into k plus 1 factorial. So you can see now, so let me erase this part and let me write it out. So what we can show from there, so from there, here you can see that here we have k plus 1 factorial, also here we have k plus 1 factorial. So what we can do, we can take k plus 1 factorial common, so as a common part, so it becomes k plus 1 factorial into, so here we have k plus 1, so here we have k plus 1, and here basically we have nothing, means here we have 1 basically, so k plus 1 plus 1 minus 1. So if you do not understand that part, so let me do it quickly for you. What we are using over here, we are using the formula for distribution, which is a plus b into c, which is a into c plus b into c. So what is a over here? So here you can see this k plus 1 is our a, so k plus 1 is our a plus 1 is our b into what is c? C is our k plus 1 factorial. So c is k plus 1 factorial, and you can see that it becomes k in plus 1 into k plus 1 factorial plus 1 into k plus 1 factorial. So you can see that by using this formula, I can write in this, from there we can write in these parts. So let me erase that part now. So here we go. So here we have this part. So from there we can write, so we can write k plus 1 factorial into k plus 2 minus 1, which is equals to k plus 2 factorial. This is from the chapter, factorial chapter, so from the permutation combination chapter you can see that. So let me repeat that formula for you. What I am doing over here, suppose we have n plus 1 into n factorial, then we can write it as n plus 1 factorial. This is the formula I am using over here. So what is over here, here you can see that here we can write k plus 2 as k plus, we can write k plus 2 as k plus 1 plus 1. So this is our n. So n plus 1 into, you can see that here we have k plus 1 factorial. So here we have n factorial. So we can write n plus 1 factorial. So we can write k plus 2 factorial over here. So we get k plus 2 factorial in our left hand side. So what about the right hand side? So let's check that. What about the right hand side? What we gonna do? We gonna erase this part. I think you understand the step I follow, and if you not, just comment me below and then we can talk about or discuss in more details, or maybe point that out where you get the difficulties. Then I can talk about that difficulty, and I want to ease your difficulty. So here we go. So here we get k plus 2 factorial minus 1 in left hand side. So what about the right hand side of Pn? When I put n equals to k plus 1 in the right hand side, so here we have the right hand side. So we put n equals to k plus 1. So you can see that we get k plus 1 plus 1 whole factorial minus 1, which is equals to k plus 2 factorial minus 1, which is clearly same with the left hand side. So here we get the left hand side and here we get the right hand side. So left hand side is same with the right hand side. So the equation, the statement is true for, so let me write that down. So the statement pn is true for n equals to k plus 1. Hence, by mathematical induction, so by the mathematical principle of mathematical induction, we can say that, so hence by mathematical induction, hence by induction or mathematical induction, you can write anything. So either induction or mathematical induction, some books also write principle of mathematical induction. So hence by induction, the statement Pn is true for all positive integers, so all n greater than or equals to 1. So let me quickly repeat summarize the parts I follow. So first let me erase this first. So here we go. So I think you understand, but let me summarize the whole parts I follow. So what you have to do actually to show that a statement is true or not, so to show what's the step follow in first step. So in first step, what you have to do, we have to find a base value. So for example, if I have to put n equals to 1, so suppose for n equals to 1 the statement is true, then our base case is n equals to 1. If the statement, so here, if pn is not true, is not true, or pn is false for n equals to 1, go to the step where we put the value n equals to 2. So if pn is true for n equals to 2, then our base case will be for this problem, so it is true for any induction problem. So in this problem, you can see that the step 1, the base case is n equals to 1, pn is true. So if it is not true for in some problem, then you will go to check for n equals to 2. If it is true for n equals to 2, then our base case will be 2. If it is not true for n equals to 2, then we go for n equals to 3, and our base case will be true if n is true for n equals to 3. In this way, we will have to go. So first step is have to show that this is true for some integers, pn is true for one of that integers. So suppose we assume here p1 is true, and it is the statement pn is true for n equals to 1 for this problem, particularly for this problem. So what we follow in the next step, so in next step or in step 2, we assume that, so assuming, so in step 2 assuming, so this is also true for any mathematical problem, any mathematical induction problem. So assuming that the Pn is true for n equals to k. So we assume that the statement is true for n equals to k. What we going to do, we put the value n equals to k and we write pk. So the we will have to write the pk, the statement, write down the statement pk over here. So write that down. So in next step 3, what we have to show by using step 2, so by using step 2, so it is your task. By using step 2, we have to show basically that pn is true for n equals to k plus 1, which means if I put the value n equals to k plus 1 over here, so in the statement if I put n equals to k plus 1, then the statement also be hold by that the value of n. For that value of n, the statement is also true. If I cancel the third step, then the principle of mathematical induction, we can say that the statement is true for any integers start from the base case. So here we have the start from the base case, start from 1, so statement is true for all positive integers n. So if it is not start from n equals to 3, then it may be true for all positive integers greater than equals to 3. So it changes with the problem, the base case changes with the problems of mathematical inductions. So I hope you understand these problems. So if you not, comment me below. I just repeat it again, comment me below where you get the difficulties to understand the problems, and also just comment me below the which type of problems you want to watch in my next video. That will be very helpful for me, so I can discuss that problems and we can communicate with each other. By now we have do not able to meet physically, but we can meet in online in this way. So I hope you are okay and staying at your home. So thank you for watching. I think you will come back in my next video. Okay, goodbye.